Australians all let us rejoice because Daryl Braithwaite is back with new music and he's definitely not horsing around. Now, you've heard this new track, Love Songs, on the radio over the past few weeks, getting a whole lot of airplay and deservedly so because it is an absolute cracker. So, Daryl was up from Melbourne the other week before the lockdown, of course. I invited him to come dining at Dickie's.
Good, Richard.
Legend alert, Daryl Braithwaite, Richard, come on in.
Ooh. How are you?
Good to see you, man. Come on in, come on in. I've got something to show you.
Okay.
Now, Daryl, you would not be aware.
No, Richard.
That you always have a presence in my house. Steps.
All right, yes.
Because that was one of the first.
Oh, gee whiz.
Gold record plucky things that I ever
received. Yeah, and that's from when you did our first, the MTV, or the MTV thing.
Performance, yeah. And that record sold out of every record store in the country the next day.
That's right. That was such a good time.
Hey, come and have a seat.
Okay.
We should have a drink to celebrate.
Oh, yeah, well, I got this. Oh, thank you, Richard.
Nice little Shiraz. Just to celebrate your success from the hit year of 1988. What year was that?
88, 89.
And you're still going gangbusters, mate. Congratulations
on
Love Songs.
Oh, thank you.
What a great song.
Yeah. Thank you. Thank you very much. I've been writing love songs since we broke up.
Guess that it took good and you to make it sure enough. What does it feel like to have hits all over again?
It's nearly surreal. It's amazing considering, you know, 71 years of age. It's like you would never have thought, or I wouldn't, back when I was 20, that you'd still be doing it at 70, like, and having a degree of success.
Well, this is like the third wave, you know?
Yeah,
There was the Sherbet wave, then there was that wave.
The solo, yeah.
And now there's this wave.
I know, it's,
I know it's work for you, you know, sorry to get you down. And I know. You were singing on The Voice the other day.
Yeah, it was. I found it quite refreshing to be there to see how they put it all together, and got to sing with Chris Sebastian.
Was there a time when suddenly The Horses became a national anthem almost?
I don't know. I don't think I've done anything bar the fact that every gig we do, we go out to sell it as being the last one. So you just, you give it your all, and with The Horses, that really hasn't gone to sleep at all. It's just, it's kept maintained and maybe gotten bigger, but.
Maybe.
But you get
about 8 minutes out of that when you do it live.
Yeah, but we've cut it back a little bit because James Rain said it's shameless.
Oh.
Good on you, James.
You're an Aussie icon, which is why I got you some Aussie and Aussie feed. All right, because you're dining at Dickie's and I've been to a lot of trouble to get you something.
Oh, okay.
Stay there.
I'll wait
here. An Aussie feast for an Aussie icon.
Did you make them yourself?
Well, I wouldn't go that far.
No, they're good.
What's the matter with that? And cheers, mate.
Yeah. Good luck.
Yum-o-o-o.
Do you know The Horses?
How does it go?
Oh, God. That's the way it's gonna be, little darling. We'll go riding on horses, yeah.
Yeah, I've heard that.
Way up in the sky, little darling. Oh, and if you fall, I'll pick you up. Oh, that might have been close, I reckon, that key.
Yeah, that's about right. Yeah,
but that was good, Richard.
Yeah, thanks, mate.
And does that pay back for the pie?
Yeah, let's get stuck into the Lamingtons now.
Yeah, all right.
Oh, does it get any better?